drop.
Why?
Where's James? I need James.
Y'all niggas is killing me today.
Look at this. Claps are free, like Max said. Oh, yeah. Y'all ain't shit. But okay, welcome. Thanks for coming through. I mean, right. A little bit of rain earlier.
You know how Miami is bipolar as weather. So like,
we lost rains. Our whole guest last week because of the rain, so I get
well,
it.
Well, they're from out of town and they wanted to ride through Miami with a convertible top. And it was raining, it was pouring here. You know, in Miami, it can be raining one section and not. So when they pulled up here,
yeah, look at the clouds.
It was pouring rain, and they was all in the convertible with the top down. And they got drenched and had to go back to the hotel and change. So that's how we lost our guests. So in future, I'm going to have to tell people who not from here to feel free to look at the weather. Or fucking just don't put the top down.
I mean, yeah. But you know, and he's out there in Atlanta, it's like, it's not like it's super cold, so why would he even have the top down? Like, it's not like when you're
from
New York.
But it's warm here, though.
When you're in New York and you come out here, you want the top down.
But it's getting chilly there, though. But you know, you rented a convertible, whatever, too, so you want to have the top down. Like, you were in Miami, top down, beach, all that, like.
Top down, dick out, like, that's how you go.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Is that how you go? I don't know. I don't know. Yo, you got a lot of kids.
How'd it go to that?
I don't know. I'm just trying to figure out what he was doing. I'm just trying to figure out what he was doing.
That went left real quick.
Welcome to Mac and Miga Live.
Right, okay. But is this after dark version? No.
It is. We started late. No, it is because we definitely started late. No. And my cousin was blaming. He got me in my feelings. He
oh my gosh.
Today. Get over it.
Right.
Here are my feelings.
Ryan, my river, bitch, you get over it.
I'm a tough bitch, but I feel like I'm stuck today.
You are emotional. Why? Because you got to get some time. Moving right along. So how's your week? Looks like it's going to end well.
It started crazy. I hate yeah, I swear to God, I hate this guy. I hate him. Neff, how are you? You look great.
Deflect.
You look great. The video was dope. You know, you and Nico did y'all thing.
Y'all did.
Yeah, I definitely did. You know, but my week was good, you know. It was what it is. We know what we had to do for my dad. I'm stuttering.
Right. It's like, you nervous?
No, I'm definitely not. Say, okay. I'm definitely not nervous.
That's what fills in on your week.
What do you say? I'm so happy to have my cousins here. DJ L Blaze always comes and shows love.
He does.
But you know,
we appreciate
bars.
It.
Bars is real flaky.
33-year-old Bars.
Oh, Bars.
Yeah, his birthday's coming up, so he's gonna be 33. You know, this is Bars.
Birthday in April.
In April? I'm talking about this month.
No, it's April plus,
oh,
plus 10 years, man. That old motherfucker.
Yeah.
That old
ass like birthday coming up.
No, but you know.
That means all our birthday coming up.
To be honest,
April.
That's my birthday too.
Right.
You a whole like what?
Aries.
Aries. I knew it. I was talking about y'all earlier.
Child.
You an Aries too?
What you were saying?
Oh, you a Taurus.
Okay. Nothing nice.
Crazy.
What's the
Aries is trash.
Oh damn.
Oh yeah, because you're early Aries.
Are we gonna have this whole back and forth thing?
Yeah.
I hope not.
Don't talk about
that. No, because I'm not here for that bullshit. I'm not here for it. At all.
Talk about you gave us an abbreviation of your week.
I didn't have no, my week was really, really low key. Like, I'm just worried about getting my kids.
But you know, we still in that week. Today's
no,
part of the week.
No, today's not part of the week.
Yes, it
my
is.
Kid, well, today my kid is getting ready for her SAT tomorrow.
Okay. Damn, I remember that.
Yeah, right?
Shit.
SAT. Yeah, SAT. Yeah.
Wow.
She's not a great student because the SATs actually don't matter now because
they
of COVID. So she's doing it. We're doing it on purpose because she's not a great student. So we need to show. She's actually a good test taker. So on her PSAT, she did like 1180.
Wow.
I'm like, bitch. My regular one, I did a 1080. So like, yeah, so for you, we need you to like take that twice. get a high grade.
Right. Yeah.
At least show that, you know, sometimes, you know, you had a lot going on.
Yeah.
Lie or something or whatever, and that's what it is.
And show out.
Lie.
There we go. Lie. Yes, yeah. Lie. I'm that parent.
Okay.
Like, we're going to make sure that we get you into where you need to go.
Just as long as we ain't doing like them other people.
No, no, we're not paying.
Right.
But Kyrie, shout out to Kyrie Aileen, who's on Vigo now. Shine anyway. Hashtag.
He has audition today, too.
I missed it. My bad. But we were on FaceTime last night, and he said that he can't. He was like, oh, is Howard on her list? I said, yes, Howard is on her list. He did apply. He was like, I'm putting in the call to Howard. I was like, motherfucker, do it. Do that.
He's like that person kind of knows. Like,
he used to work with admissions in Howard. I was
he
like,
did. I was one time on the phone with him. He was like, there.
Let's go.
He drinking from
me. What? Yeah. Sorry. But that was my week. My week was real chill. You know,
okay.
I do have a guest in town. Like, I don't even know him like that, but this is what it is.
You got a guest that you don't know?
That's I don't know him like that.
Oh, okay. That's
it's
different.
My friend's friend.
That's
and
different.
So, you know.
Details.
I thought I had seen them before on your story, but I wasn't sure. But, you know, moving right along.
Shout out to Bigo. Bigo be remembering.
I think
shit.
I seen him on Bigo too, yeah.
Yeah, he was on Bigo.
Okay, but you don't really know him that well. My week consisted of basically having a slow week because I don't really hang out on Mondays, but I hung out this Monday because my friend Crystal, it's her birthday.
Yeah.
Okay. So Trina had put something together real quick.
Shout out to Midori Star Media.
Yeah. And we went over there and it was a surprise for her because Trina didn't text her all day. I didn't text her all day once she sent me the invite. So surprise. And it was good. I actually got drunk on a Monday, which I don't normally do. So, you know, we have dance class and all that, but I ain't go to dance.
You ain't go?
No, nah, I ain't going.
Thank God I flaked.
They ain't record anyway, so.
Oh, that's
so I'm trying to make sure he ain't here or not.
He's online. He was online. He's gone.
But everything else was like me trying to get myself back together because I had a long weekend last weekend. That's why I feel like my voice ain't all the way back. Tuesday was recovery day, and then I went back to the gym. Wednesday, Thursday, and then Friday I had tennis. So yeah, I ain't really do shit. I mean, I did stuff for, I have a turkey drive coming up.
You did stuff for Major and E.
For Major E, and then I got Freezing Flow Rider part of it too.
That's
so,
what's up.
Operation Turkey that's coming up on Thanksgiving Day. Give out 1,000 meals between 12 and 3 on Thanksgiving Day. So we have the meetings for that. So yeah, we've been doing that, organizing that, and everybody coming in and playing the part. So yeah, Major Wright was one of our guests.
Yeah, call me aggressive.
Yeah.
Fuck him.
He might have called the right call.
No, he didn't. I'm nice. Ain't I nice? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, look. Shy.
Who said it?
Shout out to Shy.
Okay.
Shy. My bitch. Fuck you, Kim. My
one.
Bitch, Shy. Shy. Right. She said I'm nice. You know what I'm saying? I'm nice and soft.
I thought the other one might have said that.
Right? I'm soft, right? I'm soft as a fucking pillow. Now.
He just gave the head nod.
Ain't I nice?
Details.
Ain't no details. Look, Neff, ain't I nice?
Huh?
Oh,
shit.
He ain't
some,
and I didn't either.
Y'all bring
and
some nice ancient people. Niggas in here because I'm a nice person.
We didn't say you were mean, but you can be aggressive at times.
I think you're nice.
Thank you. I love her.
Nice. But is she aggressive?
No.
No.
We would never.
I think she real nice.
Thank you.
She nice. But she's aggressive.
I'm soft as a
aggressively
pillow.
Aggressively
nice.
Maybe.
I can't bust a grape. Right. I'm soft as a pillow.
Mika. I used to call you Mika the Mean Girl. Like.
No, he does. Don't say used to. You, nigga, you said that last week.
I haven't said it what?
You said it last fucking week. Yes, you said it on our thing. Because, well, 2 weeks ago or whatever.
Oh.
And you be like, Mika the Mean Girl. I'm so mean to people, whatever. And I am.
No, you can.
No, I am.
And
no,
she's
admitting
it. Hello.
No, I am.
But let's call it nice, though, after she just said she's
no,
mean.
Because I don't. No. Because. Mac be bringing around mad random motherfucking bitches and mad random motherfucking niggas. Like, people that we just met, he's nice. Like, oh, okay, hang out with us. I'm like, I don't know these niggas.
Mika do that, like, even on Bigo.
Even on Bigo.
No, I be having to remind her, too, like.
I wasn't nice that. When I first met you, but I was nice after that. He was around.
Even on Bigo, like with people that we kind of.
So knew, people on Bigo,
and we met,
said that to me.
And then, like, when they met her in person, she was like, what's up? And they were like,
yeah.
Right, and they were like, damn, like, we thought, and she's like, oh, hey, that's you. Oh, I didn't know, but, yeah.
Yeah, no, I am like that because I just want to make sure
no, that's true.
Around us for the right reasons. Because I have, like, not only right. dated people, like, be around people
right.
that just want to be, oh, Gina, pop, right. like, whoever, right. like, is around us. And it's, like, super, it's whack. It's cool.
I feel like I have a good eye of...
Nah. You just like
all
bad
the people
bitches.
I bring around.
You like bad bitches just being around.
But they'll be
keep it real.
They'll like spoil the move though. Like,
no,
I'm like
they don't spoil the move, but I know like they're not around for the.
Not all of them be bad. Like all, not all be like bad.
He just
bad.
like all these girls twerking and shit around. I'm like,
hey, get in there. You need the energy. You out in the club? Shit, this ain't Sunday school.
At least she's honest though.
I'm just saying, like, I'm
but the
cool
thing
with
is,
it.
A lot of them that come around,
make sure you're around for the right
for the moment.
Yeah.
And then,
that's what I'm
that's
saying.
What it
I just
is.
Want to make sure.
Yeah, so they, like, they're going to hang with us on the regular. Like, you know what I mean? It's
yeah.
Just like, oh.
And then they in my face.
We
I'm like,
party
don't
space.
Be in my face.
Okay, yeah, that's
my thing.
She's
like,
just trying to make sure
face.
That they know that.
She I think they know that because I don't think I'm going to go out nowhere else. Like,
no, no, but they'll be in my, they'll be like, hey. I'm like, hey. Like, we're not friends. Like,
yeah.
But you ain't got to make it seem like y'all ain't friends. Like,
we not friends.
Like,
we not friends.
I probably won't see you no more after this,
world.
But hey, let's have a good time tonight.
You're crazy.
So
no, I am the mean girl, I guess. And I own
and
it.
It's not that either. It's
what?
Like, it's other things for people that you've been a little mean.
No.
Feel
call
like,
me on it.
Now people
say
feel
what
like
it
I
is.
Can be mean, but it's like you have to push me a little bit more to be mean, but me could just
no,
be
no.
Like,
you're no, listen. Mac is not mean when he meets you. But Mac is a because
you
asshole.
Did something. Because you
Mac,
did something at that point.
Did something.
Because
like if you
I was
do
being
something,
nice and now you did something.
Mac will want to fight
so
you. Mac will hem you up like the Incredible Hulk.
It's like you crossed the line
at the party.
At the because now it's like you felt
like
what you
like,
want to do.
No, why you do that?
I'ma check it because you thought I was so nice and I'm. And to a certain extent, but don't try to play.
Well, I'm very sweet. Yeah.
But Mika from the beginning will be the person who is like.
But that's maybe that's her defense mechanism.
No, so one of my things is this. Okay, let's talk about it. Let's shake the room. We
let's
got three,
get into it.
We got three,
maybe that's the defense mechanism.
We got 3 minutes.
Let's shake the motherfucking room. So, you know, I group around real niggas.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You're a real nigga.
Yeah.
You know, and Mac don't like you paying for nothing and things like that. But I also feel like Mac shouldn't always be paying
right.
for everything.
She says that.
So me and like a like Chanel, like
yeah,
we'll
people.
Come out and these are girls. That we'll come out and we'll be like, yo, let's get bottles.
Right,
like,
that's true.
Mac don't have to pay.
Blah,
but then
so,
you're blind,
yeah,
of course.
Yeah.
But they'll be like grown ass niggas.
She
not
like,
Larry. Not them.
No, not
nobody I bring around. They be like, oh.
She be like, well, how the fuck they allow me to pull my
card
out?
Yeah,
and then
I
say like,
shit.
Well, let me pull out and try to help.
But I'm talking about like
that's
not even a guy that I bring around. I'm talking about like a random dude will come and be like, he's trying to be at our table. And then he's just chilling. And me and Chanel be like, we're treating tonight. Not Mac not pulling out. And this nigga is really watch all these niggas. Because it'll be like 3, 4, 5 of them. And they'll watch
not
us.
At one time. That's
at one time. About 3. Because we'll have about 15 people.
So let's say
back.
3
let's
people.
Keep it. So 3 guys while me and Chanel and not even Block. It'll be me, Chanel, and Grace at the time.
Yeah.
We'll pull out.
Yeah.
And we'll pull out.
They'll pull out. They'll get food. They'll get liquor.
We get liquor. And these guys is over here
and
chilling.
Like,
and they trying to grind. Oh, they ain't grinding on me, nigga. But they grinding. And
they
the
trying
air.
To make their way. And it's like.
On the air.
You can sit here and watch. And y'all don't know the scenario, though. But the girls tonight is like, well, we ain't finna let you pay. Because you always do so. Okay, we got it tonight. So now, so you see these girls boss up. And they doing some things. And now it's like. But damn, nigga, how you feel like you going to holler at them? And they looking at you like, well. You don't
yeah.
even buy us a drink, you ain't, you're like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what's this about?
It's like you don't even have to even offer to buy a drink because we done bought 3 bottles,
hello.
Bad food,
right.
all kind of shit at the table. And let's not talk about the games. I missed the game, but we'll talk about sports later.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, like, we'll be, you know, in there.
That's true, too.
You know, and doing it, whatever.
That's true.
And these guys.
I don't know, I feel like some guys don't have that, like.
They ain't grow right. They wasn't
some,
raised
they
right.
just feel like, okay. I feel like some guys are used to their mom take care of them, so then they feel like the
yeah.
girls will take care of them too, I guess. I don't know. They,
and you know,
they don't have that in them.
That's cool for them.
But I feel like my mom, like, you know, my mom worked hard, and I watched her work hard, but I feel like Nah, like.
Yeah, you're not like that. You've never been like that.
Yeah, so I feel like.
That's what made me always be like. And because I'm from the thing where the dude always pays every, you know, yeah. Like you don't see the girl pull out. But when I see you always doing for so many people, we always come out. We be like, nah, here's a round. Okay. Here's a bottle. Yeah, here's whatever.
Yeah.
And that's what it is.
But, you know, DJ Obliz is giving me that cue. We're going to take a little quick break.
Yeah.
Thank you, James Bond.
James Bond, fuck you. You ain't been on my live in a long time.
Go over
time.
To Beagle Live.
Go on my live.
What's
up? But like, shout out to you guys. Shout out to Beagle. Shout out to you guys. We're coming back. This break is brought to you by Repent. Hangover Cure.
It'll be back soon once we're all able to be outside again.
No, you know I'm the west side.
Hey.
Let's get lit. Welcome back to Mac and Mika Live. Y'all are whack. Oh, y'all did nothing.
Cause everybody eating now. Hello.
Shout out to Brian.
Let's do it again.
We'll do it one more time. Welcome back to Mac and Mika Live.
Brian
for the pizza.
Shout out to Brian. Not me, Brian.
Brian, not Brian. I hate when people call you Brian and they think they know you. When people call you Brian
I always
and they think they know you.
You know, people down here fuck my last name up too. They call me Kenzie.
Oh, they do? I've never heard that. That's crazy.
Oh.
Y'all too loud. I'm just going to say. Vontae.
Not Vontae by the mic.
You're the whole videographer, man.
Like, oh shit.
See right behind it.
No, but I just want to say thank you again to everybody for coming out because we know we're still in the whole pandemic.
We are.
And we're trying to keep it limited, but thank you for coming out.
Keep it limited and we have space.
But let's get into these sports. Your Dolphins are now 4-3. You were there against the Rams on Sunday, right?
And I asked you to come.
You asked me to come. My dad's birthday.
I gotta start inviting Larry.
Jay didn't make it. Jay, this my dad. Larry didn't say happy birthday. Nobody said happy birthday.
I'm mad I ain't make it.
You mad you didn't make it to the game?
Is it the opposite?
I feel away about that.
No, if I get the tickets like last minute, is it like... Okay, so I'm definitely gonna start inviting Larry.
I'm a last minute person. That's me. I'm any kind of person. But I actually, like... That was, I always go.
Yeah, we went. I'm going to tell you what's funny. It's like, the Dolphins been had people in the stadium. I've been there since the first game. So, like, some stadiums are not just letting people in. We actually got past the other week we talked about it. They're allowed that.
It's like 13,000 and stuff like that?
No, it's been 30,000 since I first was born. Wow. But they told them they could fill the whole stadium. But they haven't. They're still keeping space. So, I appreciate that.
I love going to those games, though.
What up, Kyrie Ali?
I'm going to be in North Carolina. Who?
Kyrie.
Hi, Kyrie. I'm going to be in North Carolina this weekend, so I can't make it this weekend if you go again.
This weekend?
I'm going on Sunday. I leave for North Carolina.
Damn, you didn't say nothing.
I told you when I told you. I did.
What's going on in
Carolina?
You asked me
what?
What's out there, and I think you thought it was a nigga. But
well, I don't think that I knew it was like this weekend. You must have told me like a couple weeks ago.
No, I told you a couple days ago. I said, yeah, I'm not going to be here for a thing. I was like,
you did.
New godson. Yeah, I said it's a blessing. And
when you come back?
I come back on Thursday. So come back.
Oh, okay.
I'll be here.
All right, so you'll be Sunday?
Sunday to Thursday.
Oh, okay.
But I can't wait to go to the games. I love going to the games. But what was the whole turn? Because I saw the Rams were up. I saw the Rams were up early.
Yeah. But then after that, it was like the Dolphins. I ain't going to lie. I ain't go to the Rams game thinking that I was going to see the Dolphins win. But after like we don't want
to Rams game at Hard Rock.
Next thing I know, it was like 28-10. I'm like, damn, they beating their ass. So
they killed
it. Go Dolphins.
Shout out to them. But you know what? One of the things that I'm
shine anyway.
Oh, hey Kyrie. Hashtag shine anyway.
Kyrie actually was at the game too.
Yeah, I saw the picture after the fact.
I didn't even know he was coming.
Oh.
No, he walked in. I
so
like,
me and Kyrie had a people. Whole me and Kyrie had a whole FaceTime last night. And he was like, "Bitch, you unfollowed me." I said, "No, I followed you because you unfollowed me." Like,
yeah, so Kyrie, you unfollow people, they're gonna follow your ass back. Hello.
After the whole fight, the whole argument with you and him being a great dancer and all kind of shit.
He wanted us to say great.
Yeah. But it doesn't even matter. But he brought up some shit and he was saying like, what he said.
He said we started the convo.
No, I didn't. You said.
We not gonna argue with comments over here.
You said, oh, good thing you like unblock, whatever.
He said, but I love y'all.
And I said, well, you blocked me. You like unfollow me first. I would have never unfollowed you. Like, I unfollowed you because you unfollowed me. And I didn't even know you unfollowed me, but when Chanel said you unfollowed, I said, let me check my unfollows. And I saw you unfollowed me. And I said,
bros and random person.
You know, but
anyway. Let's get the sport.
But like, yeah, no. But you know, one thing that I'm glad to see that the NFL and any sport really is taking precautions with this whole pandemic still going on and everything. We don't have a vaccine. I like to see that they're taking precautions and they have protocols in place or whatever. But why can't your people follow precautions?
Well, who's my people?
Because we got the Raiders and fines.
But
we got
my people's.
My boy Tomlin and the Steelers.
I played for the Ravens, not the Raiders.
I'm just saying, like, you're an NFL guy. Oh. Like, why can't they listen to that?
But you got
to
look at all those people. You got 53 people per team.
Okay.
One person's bound to.
Because you have, like, the Raiders fine over $600,000 between the coaches.
He wasn't wearing no mask. That's why they fine.
No. With the Raiders, they were fine because they weren't following protocols for two different things.
Yeah.
But Tomlin, they wasn't wearing masks against your Ravens.
And, but then the Raiders suit coach, he wasn't wearing it on the sidelines like he's supposed to.
I know a few things that happened. Yeah. They said that they were fine to him. And I'm like, damn, like, why can't they just follow protocol?
And the thing about it is, your fine goes to a charity. And you can dispute your fine, but it goes to a charity.
Not in the NBA, I've seen
and then what y'all don't know is the NFL is basically a non-profit. That means you don't pay taxes. Mm. How the fuck you got this big ass? I need to try to give you some money and I can buy a team. I ain't got to pay tax, make all this money, I ain't got to pay tax on it. This is a non-profit.
I didn't know the NFL was a non-profit.
Yeah, it's a non-profit.
Oh, shit.
It's been a non-profit for time now. That's crazy. So that's why they love Trump and you know, and when he said in a couple years ago, tell them not to take a knee, hello, because we don't want you to change nothing about us. You know, billionaires who ain't got to pay no damn tax off all this money you fucking making. Makes sense now, don't it?
Now it does.
Yeah.
It did it then, like you said. But, like, what I...
So they going to go with, listen, don't mess with our money. So, we're going to do what you say.
Don't fuck with us.
One time, I don't know if I told you this before. One time I was on a plane with my owner, when I played with the Vikings, he's from New Jersey. So me and him had to fly to New York together. We took his private plane. And I was sitting here like, I know what you pay me, and I know what you pay a couple other people in here on my team.
And you still got a private plane.
You got a private plane. You got to pay all the bills.
The license.
How you how you got all this money? And you and he was like maybe like 52 or something. I'm like, what you did? Nah, he wasn't like an old man. Like he was like, you know, multiple streams of income. He's he's a Jewish guy. His brother's a part owner too. You know, brought his family in, but he was like. Model streams of income. He says, I started with strip malls. He says, the thing is, people think multiple streams and then they try to put a whole bunch of energy in all those things. He says, just focus on the thing that you really feel like could go. He says, when it goes, you can use that funding to start the other things that you already may have, but like start putting marketing to it, start doing all those things. He said, but you can't put all energy into everything. Like, you just got to trust which one you pick and guess the strip malls was it. Strip malls blew up, and then it was like, now I'm going to take the money I'm getting from here and put it here now, because I already had all these other businesses. And then they started going, and shit, next thing you know, he didn't bought a team. So, I always be inquired. I always ask questions, because I had time to be around him.
You ask questions.
Because the thing about it was, I was in trouble, and he actually was going to see the commissioner. But that lets you know how valuable I was to the team. Shit, I flew him on his private jet, lived up there. And he was like, I'm going with you guys, support you. I always fuck with him. So even when I went to Minnesota,
two years ago,
guess when I was in Minnesota, I was getting in trouble. Glad there wasn't no social
media. Boat gate, guys.
Glad there wasn't no social media then. But he had my back and he went to the meeting with me. And
anybody in here remember Boat Gate?
They was young.
They was young, but they wasn't.
A lot of them was young. But, shit, he had my motherfucking back, so I always respect him every time I see him. Like, and like one time, one of his securities was outside when I was there hosting like a suite. They have corporate suites. And then I was like, I want to speak to them. And they were like, they don't have people coming. Da, 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 da. And I said, I'm going to be back. I said, I got to go down here and be in the suite for like 10, 15 minutes to host it. And then I'm coming back. When I come back, I'm coming in. And he was like, I said, so you need to talk to them while I'm going. You have to talk to people sometimes like you're supposed to be somewhere. Like, don't let somebody always dictate like what you can do, what you can. No. And I'm talking to you in a way my body language never tell you, like, they know who I am. You're like, you know what I'm saying? That's how you have to be. You can't be like, well, I ain't sure. Like, no. I'm talking to you like they know me very well. Like, and they, that was the energy he got.
They know who the fuck I am.
That security didn't. But when I brought my ass back, he stopped me like, oh, hey, yeah, you said you were. I said, yeah. Yeah, ho. And I went in there. We took pictures. All they're like, well, he normally don't take pictures. We took pictures. We did everything you said he wasn't going to do. Right. Yeah. That's how it is. Shit. You got to act like you belong places. Stop acting like you ain't sure. Because the motherfucker look like, they look at you like, they don't know they supposed to be here. It's on your body language, it's your face, and they're going to kind of be like, hey, are you lost? Like, they're going to come in, they can read it. Shit. Every time I go somewhere, yeah, we supposed to be here. I learned that shit from a young age. Place I wasn't supposed to be.
At all.
They help guide you, like, they help guide you where you're supposed to be. I ain't supposed to be here, but thank you.
You ain't shit. But let's get into Julio Jones, who I love personally. I've always loved him. I've always thought he was super athletic. Like, he was a fast dude. I've always loved him.
Yeah.
And him and Devontae Adams have both come out and said, on record, in the media, that they are the best wide receivers in the game.
I mean, really, how you end that too? Because, well, being the best is something is like really a lot about consistency. But then, and they're talking about this season, you just look at the numbers at the end of the season.
I mean, you look at the numbers, but I feel like there's other people too. Are we just not considering other people?
You have the rookie from Minnesota, right? Oh, Metcalf, yeah.
You were talking about the rookie from Minnesota.
Yeah, Jefferson.
Okay.
But so, yeah, Metcalf, as we watch him run somebody down. Yeah, we definitely like. Julio has been one of those consistent receivers for a while, so I get why he said it. But you definitely have other people on the rise.
It's crazy. Yeah, I thought somebody to my left said they had a lot to say about this topic.
I don't think he knows the topic. We have to say it again.
I don't even want to say it again. I hate you.
Devontae Adams.
Yeah, there we go.
He the one.
You split another drink.
Over Metcalf?
Right now, yeah.
That's what I was talking about, DeAndre Hopkins. No, I feel like...
DeAndre Hopkins.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you don't even have DeAndre Hopkins in the conversation.
And
like,
then you have... Brian, you have Jefferson.
Okay, who's downstairs?
And Minnesota, too.
Is that the... No,
that's
Brian.
No. That's on Neff.
Listen.
Neff, shut up!
Process of elimination. Who was up here? Who ain't here?
Devontae Adams is the one that's... killing everything right now. So he got the right to say that. Right now.
That's what I was saying. Like, you got to look at the numbers.
Maybe Julio, but...
Okay, he got the right to say,
but I feel like Julio is probably more consistently...
I think so. I think Devontae Adams right now.
So you're saying this season or overall?
I mean, it's not like Devontae Adams hasn't been performing, you know, overall. So...
No, I'm saying as far as, like, longevity.
He'll be back to DeAndre. I think so, too.
DeAndre needs his love, man.
Nah, I like
Adams. Get live.
I like Adams.
Well, tell us why.
Did you see the game, Doc, last night?
Say we didn't.
You didn't? So, we gotta talk about it.
So, he's been doing that every game of the season that he has played this year. And
what about Jefferson in Minnesota? Because he is in the top three, maybe, of receivers overall. He's only a rookie.
Only a rookie.
But that's what I'm saying. That's what I said. Well, Julio has been around longer than Adams, right?
So, like, that's the...
That, and that's why I said longevity and still in the top. Like,
but Adams has been doing it for a long time, too. Maybe not as long as Julio.
So argument about the other one being a rookie, but the other one, like, doing it long, but not as long, like, so what's the difference?
I mean, it's still some years put in.
Right.
It's still some years put in for both Julio and Devontae Adams. So, Devontae Adams.
I feel like when Odell came out, everybody, like, his first 2 years was all like, hey.
It was all day.
Yeah.
And if he would have kept it up, then he would be in this conversation.
But then it's like, who's the quarterback that's throwing the rock? Like, so
that plays a factor too.
Maybe.
And then your offensive line, that's the engine.
Yeah.
If you got a terrible offensive line, the quarterback can't throw the ball.
Tell him about it, B Mac. So,
there's a lot of things that factors into the receivers getting the ball.
Yeah, true.
My whole phone fell. Sorry, guys.
My whole facts is just off fantasy football. My bad.
I got you.
No, that's me too.
Fantasy football. Adams is killing.
DeAndre, we want him some money.
Oh.
No, but I say I always look at stuff. If I was to start a team with him, would I pick Adams over Hopkins? I don't know. I think I would go Hopkins.
Yeah.
For me, but, me personally.
But I think you've been doing that because of the consistency.
No, I see what he did in Houston, and then yeah. Now he's in Arizona with a young, improving quarterback.
So you say you pick who? Hopkins?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Cause yeah, he went to a whole other team, and sometimes people aren't used to being in a system. Like some people are in a system. And when they leave that system, it's not good for them. Like, they just, you be like, damn, what happened to them? But, like, he's consistently just a talented person. He can go to another team and still make it happen.
So, for me, unfortunately, I'm a Jets fan, right? So
unfortunately,
I'm a Jets fan.
But did you see that catch by Odell Beckham? That one-handed catch.
No, that's the Giants. But,
that's what I said. Did you see that? Because, you know, like the Jets.
5 years ago.
Yeah,
no, it was the other day because you was watching
no, but,
and I was on the phone with you, nigga. We was on the phone.
I'm talking about Robbie Anderson.
I didn't see them in real time. I saw it in the highlights. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, I saw that after the fact, too.
The Ravens can possibly. Somebody asked me, do I think the Ravens can make the Super Bowl? They have potential to because I feel like the two teams they lost to, Pittsburgh and Kansas City, it's hard to beat a good team twice. So it's. They have to see them again. They have the potential to win.
Yeah.
And you're going to see for sure Pittsburgh again because that's in your conference.
Well, Justin, you're running that ball board.
They talking about your Jets, Jay.
No, they suck. I mean, I ain't going to lie.
There's a young kid on there. He's, I think, a tackle.
Jokai Beckham.
Yeah, him. So yeah. They compared us saying he was Big Mac.
Yeah.
2.0, like the new version.
Yeah, I saw that article.
But I haven't seen him play yet, but I think I'm going to go.
He's a monster.
Okay, so
he's
when they play
monster.
The, when they play the Dolphins.
Yeah, no.
When did they play the Dolphins? When did Jets play? I don't know.
Listen,
it's so bad I stopped following the schedule, but I still love them.
That's what happened with me and the Giants. So when we were talking and he was like, oh my God, did you see a catch? I was like, no, nigga, I fucking gave up on him.
All right,
I was so mad. But I seen that shit in the highlights. I was like, one-handed catch.
One more question. Somebody on Beagle asked, is Carson Wentz considered an elite quarterback?
No.
No. Well, everybody said no quick.
Yeah,
so
they said it was
no.
A hot picnic.
No.
No. No.
Hell.
No.
That's their cousin.
No. He lost it.
That's their cousin on Beagle.
I hope not. No, they from Philly. But no, he's not considered an elite quarterback. Sorry.
He didn't win him a Super Bowl.
Sorry.
Nick Foles did.
Who did?
Nick Foles won a
Super Bowl. Yeah, Foles. They said Foles won a Super Bowl. Not Wentz, but you know, Wentz is holding on. But this concludes our sports segment.
Yeah, we're gonna come back in 5 more minutes, and we're gonna end it out with trending topics, and we have a question of the day that I really want to hear from you guys about.
Oh shit!
Because
I don't even know what it is, so I'm excited.
Oh, like you try to hide the guess from me?
Right, that's fine.
I hide the question
and
of the day from you.
I'm okay.
There we go. DJ L Blaze, let's take us out.
Drop that shit.
Play my-
Welcome back to Mac and Beagle Live! Woo! Okay. Welcome back to our last segment. Trending topics and other.
You sure?
What?
I'm
just sharing my mind. We said 5 minutes. Okay, he's still sharing his live. But let's.
Let's talk about the election.
Let's talk about the election.
Oh, please, no.
Kanye.
Oh, shit.
I'm mad at that people were voting for Kanye in certain states.
First and foremost, they voted for
Yeah,
Kanye.
They were. He had like 50,000 in one state.
They also voted for the other independent lady.
Yo, you remember when Barack, they had the old guy that was named D's Nuts?
I remember that.
It was a guy that people were voting for, but his name was D's Nuts.
And he was getting
Pennsylvania
voted.
And Georgia, they flipped. They were red states, and they flipped to blue.
Well, they are flipping because we don't have a final, right?
No, but their colors went from red to blue.
Yeah, because they're flipping right now.
Yeah.
And I love that. And I saw, like, you know, having lived out there and seeing people migrate out there to Atlanta or to Georgia, I already knew that they were going to flip. And I was wondering, like, I remember living out there, no lie, and, like, down the block, we were in one gated community, and down the block there was it wasn't even a community, it was like one gated house. Mm. He had a Confederate flag, and I remember saying, that's legal? Like, I didn't even know, like, because I'm coming from New York, which is, I lived in Atlanta, I lived a lot of
Atlanta,
places.
Atlanta, you'll drive down the highway, and you'll see a Confederate flag.
Yeah, but this guy had it outside of his gate for his house.
You can drive in Davie and see that.
Well, that's what I was going to say. I live in Davie, and so... When I'm talking to my other kids, Southwest, for real, that's where she at. But people were telling me, they were like, yo, it's so racist over there. And I was like, really? And they were like, when they used to, so this guy, my kid's classmate's father, now he's married to the mother, obviously. But he was like, I used to date this white girl over there. He black. He was like, I used to date this white girl back there. He was like, I used to go over there, and they were really, like, super racist.
Yeah.
He said they used to chase him down the street. And
what?
The one time the girl came out, and because she was screaming, her father came out. Was like, leave him alone. And the father had to stand up for him. But it's crazy. Like, I didn't know it was like that. But I'm not deep in Davie, okay? I'm by the highway. I'm not by camp.
But I always be wondering, like, why are they more mad than us? Like, y'all the ones who fucked us over for a long time.
Nobody.
So, like, what the fuck y'all mad about? Bitch, we should have that attitude.
That's true.
Wanna hang y'all.
Wanna hang y'all.
But, like, what I'm really confused about is, like, the unicorns, the Cuban, like, you know what I'm saying?
About their history about being a Republican.
Okay.
That favored them for a while, and they kind of stuck with that.
But what I don't understand is that.
So with Castro, so it's like the wet foot, dry foot thing, whatever. Like,
but what I don't understand is that how could y'all support somebody who puts y'all people in cages?
I think it's just traditional at this point.
No,
he got the people in cages, and then like.
But I feel like that was more like Mexico, too. So the Cubans don't look at themselves as Mexicans.
Right.
They look at Mexicans as the bottom of the barrel.
So you
have to look at all the different ones. Are like everybody has their, like, you have Cuban, Puerto Rican, Dominican. Are like,
yeah.
It's like in New York.
So
Dominicans,
you have,
Puerto Ricans, they feel like one.
So you have, to them, the Mexicans are at the bottom of the barrel. So that's the difference. You know what I'm saying? So they feel like, oh, no, not us. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Children, you see that, like, Trump is like putting y'all in fucking cages.
Cages.
But they're not gonna say y'all because they're not Mexican.
But it doesn't matter, y'all all speak the same language, ain't it?
I'm just a messenger.
Don't
shoot this motherfucker, please.
No, I'm not.
I'm not.
I'm just telling you, like, how the thought process with some people.
That's ignorant. That's ignorant.
It is ignorant.
Now, hold on real quick. If you've been watching what Trump's been saying, he's actually been speaking towards those people.
No, for sure. For sure, he comes down here and speaks specifically towards the Cuban
people. Right, so he lets them know, like, listen, we're not going to be communist.
So they feel
but
safe.
But it doesn't matter.
He's
no.
making them safe.
Right.
But how are y'all safe if you see someone who's
nobody
just like you and has the same, who speaks the same language?
Hold on.
The people
love the DJ.
The guy with the red shirt is talking?
The pink shirt.
That's right.
Okay. Pink and white. But I'm saying that the people who speak the same language as you, these people speak the same language as you. They go through the same struggles as you, even though they're not from the same country as you, but they're still going through the same struggles as you. And just because they're not the same race as you or they're not Cuban like you, like
it's
okay.
Not regular Cubans.
Like, it doesn't matter.
Rich Cubans.
It doesn't matter. You're Hispanic, they're Hispanic. They're in cages, like, bitch,
because
you're
well, because
rich. Well, because
rich Cubans. Because, wait, if you know about Cuba, Cuba got either rich or poor, too. It's like, that's like a lot of places, too. So
Cubans think that.
So because they're the
left. Let's find something to say.
We gotta wait one at a time, though.
Let's find something to say. Look at him.
No saying. No saying.
I'm going to say this because I got a lot of partners from La Havana.
Okay, let's hear it.
Cubans and all that.
Yeah.
From what I got from them, they racist. They racist to their own people.
Mm-hmm.
So you have some.
They racist to their own.
To their
like,
own people.
So but to the social, like to the social,
no.
Like, the economic.
No. If their own people,
color.
If their own people is my color, they don't fuck with it.
Okay. Yeah.
So if you're not as like them,
They don't fuck with it.
Okay, so I'm going to tell you somebody who's Cuban. It's Chrissy Lampton is half Cuban.
Yeah.
And Juju's Cuban.
Yeah.
Wait, Juju who?
Juju of Love and Hip Hop.
I love her.
She's Afro Latina.
I love her.
Anybody who I feel like is dark, they're gonna say it's Afro Latina.
I love me some Juju.
That's what she was saying. Amara is the same way.
I love me some Amara Lanegra.
What y'all don't know is Lala Vesquez. Is Afro Latina.
Yeah.
So anybody who's more of a darker complexion, you're gonna say Afro Latina.
Yeah.
We do that,
but that's what they. That's what they.
I mean, I do that shit.
Yeah, that's what they identify themselves as, though.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like it's not. It's not.
Latina, they don't like. You.
They don't.
Yeah. But the crazy thing about it is, because I talked to some, would have people who are his complexion in their family and your complexion in their family, but y'all all in the same family.
I have a, exactly.
They don't like you because you're dark.
No,
that's crazy.
I have one
we're
question.
All related.
Exactly. Exactly. That's my point.
But it's colorism.
That's
well, that is, and I mean, I think that goes back, way back. Because, I mean, we from Belize, and our family is like that because they will be, like, literally, like, coolie in one and, like, lighter, and they'll be like, why you bring that black boy over here?
Yeah.
My parents will tell me stories. His parents will tell me stories.
Well,
and it's just, like, it's just the way it is, and it sucks.
But why do you feel different?
I mean, we just got to know that we got to grow from that.
Yeah.
Why do you feel like it's that way?
Do you feel like it's that way
because society makes it seem like it's darker complexion?
Well, I think for Belize, like, they look to America just like other people, like Jamaicans, everybody look to America like, oh, that's better. So, like, light skin or lighter is just better in general.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's what I think.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like that's
who started that, though?
I don't fucking know.
White people.
It is, man.
But we say slavery, but like...
White people.
It was known.
So they call it division, because it made people jealous, because like, I'm out here fucking working hard.
Yeah, but you still get raped.
That's true,
What if you was a house
you having a baby
still? For sure.
You having
a
baby
still.
Outdoors, you having a baby in the house, you having a baby still.
We having
a
baby.
But
if
the
you lied, right you in the house.
If you was a house.
One time at band camp.
I want to hear what happened at band camp.
Bitches that I nutted in.
It was a joke.
It's a whole joke. Sorry, guys. Only we got it.
That's just crazy to me.
That is crazy.
This is your people.
Honestly, I didn't know that, like... I didn't know Hispanics had the same colorism effect.
You should have known that in Jersey, though, Matt. Because we in New York.
If you Puerto Rican and you got black hair, you're black. That's how it looks.
In New York, it was a very distinct thing with Puerto Ricans and Dominicans.
See, not for us. It's like, you're Puerto Rican, you speak Spanish, but you look like a light-skinned black person.
Nah, they were like, oh, we bet. It was a very big thing.
Yeah. Dominicans are like the black Spanish.
That's the black ones. Like, yeah, black Spanish. And it was like weird. Like,
it's like Dominican, Puerto Rican.
But you have Puerto Ricans who look black. Like,
yeah.
Hernandez looks black. Like,
that bitch black.
I always look to her as like
Afro Latina.
Yeah.
She's Afro
Latina.
But she speaks more out Spanish. In her head, she's black. She thinks of herself as us.
Dominican Republic, because when I was out there, I was in PR for 6 months, and while I'm out there, I'm not Spanish, my parents from Belize, everybody thought I was Dominican.
Mm.
Why is the DJ talking?
I hate the fucking DJ!
Y'all stop.
You know what I'm saying?
So what classifies you?
Stop.
My question is it because your skin color?
I'm uncomfortable.
Even if Biden got Georgia, the fact that they still have to do a recount. Oh, yeah, that's nuts.
Yeah,
that's fucking nuts.
They said that today. The
regardless,
they
because
so if Biden
that's whack.
No,
regardless,
they have a recount. You have to.
They ordered a recount.
You that's have to whack. Be. You have to be 30,000 plus to avoid a recount. So if you're under 30,000, you have to do a recount regardless. So the fact that Georgia has to do a recount because Biden's in the lead by like a couple thousand, that's crazy to me. That's crazy to me because they can end this shit right now, but they have to do a recount. So we have Georgia, Pennsylvania, and Nevada. Nevada and Pennsylvania are going to take fucking by the end of the week.
I've never
that's
seen
nuts.
An election go
I've
like this.
I've never in my lifetime. Never.
It's like, I wake up every day nervous like.
In my life.
I was telling my kids.
What I miss.
I was telling my kids that we used to wake up and we know what's going on. This is
yeah,
crazy.
The next day.
They don't know.
That night or the next day, it's like.
Nuts.
It's like 2 days in a row.
Two.
And then everyone posted me like, shit and be like, sight, when you swipe back, I'm like, come on. It was like, Biden at 264, and all of a sudden he had
214.
I'm like.
Come back 214.
That's crazy.
That's nuts.
Come on, grow up. Y'all playing with my emotions at this point.
But we have to go into the last topic because I spoke to Mac last week.
The last? I had a bunch.
The last.
You see the time? Oh. Who shows out of here? Man. We are ready to go?
No, my God.
Oh, okay. I'm going to ask them. Well, let me hear what the last topic is. All right. That wasn't even our topic that we were talking about.
Bye.
You carry that on for about a good 10 minutes.
Hello.
But okay. All right, well, let me just say this. Cali has passed Proposition 17 to restore.
I love that.
The rights for the votes of the felons.
Okay.
That's on patrol.
Let's
so I appreciate
parole,
that.
Parole.
These drinks is kicking in.
Big Paw Patrol.
I can't even read my own writing.
Big Paw Patrol.
This is Ryan. Not Larry, not Mars.
It is. It's too many. It is.
But wait,
it
what?
Has been extended version.
Shit. In what state?
Oh, shit.
In what state do they get? What state are you talking about?
How you took my phone back off the charger?
Okay. My bad. It's about to die.
What are you talking about?
Go ahead. It's about to die.
Just in general.
So,
yeah.
Okay.
All right. So I'm gonna just say my other topics then.
Go ahead. Do you?
Future is accused of providing fraudulent information in his child support case with our friend Eliza Rain, because that's our friend.
Yes, friend to the show, Eliza Rain.
Claiming to live in a two-bedroom, two-bath home in ATL, and he doesn't own any jewelry. How smart do you think this is?
When you'll be on Instagram every day.
Facts.
And, like, this is why people got to start, like, flaunting stuff. They go back and say, they're like, when'd you lose all this shit?
Because I will say this. In my divorce, we used a lot of Instagram.
Is it available?
We did. It was there.
Alright, so nobody had anything to say about that?
Wait, I have
a
question.
Okay,
so what you're saying is that, like, this guy has no proof on Instagram that he's flaunting shit.
This guy, you know who Future is?
Oh, Future.
Future.
Okay, cool. So what was the question?
I said Future was accused of providing fraudulent information in his child support case versus Eliza Rain, claiming that he lives in a two-bedroom, two-bedroom home in ATL and doesn't own any jewelry.
So he was trying to basically say, like, I don't got like that.
That's what he's saying. So if he's going to have to pay child support. That's going to be lower.
So, okay. I mean,
because, you know, when you put all that in, you know, they're basically like sworn in.
Yeah.
You might as well go to jail. But
No, but if they can't prove that he don't got like, if they can prove.
And that's the thing is, they can't really prove. He said, oh, that's this person, that person. He done moves the shit around, but oh well.
They can't prove that he don't got it like that.
We'll see.
If it's IG.
Keywords, we'll see.
But I'm saying if it's IG, it's
Eliza
like,
and Van will
it's prove
that.
It's not just IG. It's not just IG. We'll just
go ahead.
He should just do the right thing.
He should
this
do the right thing.
All this damn money with litigation, motherfucking lawyers. Y'all been going at it for these. I don't even want to see y'all on fucking.
Yeah, I kind of feel like that too. I do feel like he spent so much. Like, he spent so much flaunting private jets for his two kids' moms.
Yeah.
And, like, their birthdays. Like, at this point, just like. Just do something with her.
Is it because like it's like the new baby mama?
No, I think it's
the one who just
fighting.
Don't wanna. Cause like it was another one the same as her, but the other one gave in. And she
it.
Like
oh, it's a new one. It's a new one that he's trying to like.
It's not she's not
her.
New. Like
she not new.
Their baby's over 1 year old. Like she's not new. Like is she? It was another one the same time as her, but the other one signed and gave in and can't speak on it. This one is like no, I'm gonna stay on my ground. Like cause I really don't need you, but you gonna pay still.
You gonna do what you gotta do.
Would you help?
Y'all girls just
tried
to.
Hold on.
Shut what? The fuck up over there. I know you
want to
laugh.
Yes,
what?
Run it back. Yo, what? Brian laughing.
Wait.
Let's be very clear.
Run
it back. Yo, girls,
what? Right?
Herbo wants to pay $36,000 a year for someone to just roll his blunts and roll with him because he's tired of rolling blunts. Who would take the job?
Me? I purl them bitches.
Right, I mean, I feel like I at this point, bitches. It's like, he's tired of rolling blunts. He's like, I'm going to give you $36,000. You travel with me. You go everywhere I go, so you ain't pay for nothing.
I purl them bitches.
You basically hanging out.
You basically get to hang out.
If you have a job, would you leave your job and stay left?
You're not leaving your job. This is like a sign of
if you have to leave your job. Yeah.
You live. If that man got a show in LA, you got to leave and go in LA.
My bad. I missed that part.
I feel like it has to be how many years experience.
My bad.
Do I got to battle somebody some more?
I'm going to do 401k and rock the band with this.
Right. I feel like this would be somebody young. Like somebody young that take this. But I mean, $36,000 for a year and you travel with him? Like,
wait. But is it tax free? I didn't ask about that.
Well, shit, I don't know. He didn't see that part.
I can ask you a big thing. Okay. Some people would. I might not take it.
No,
$36,000. I might not take it, but it might be a good thing.
Right, shit. I'm retired. I might not. I need to have a roll with some blood.
I can
practice.
Practice
gets you better.
Practice
Right. All right, so I might think about that.
You might.
I ain't got to smoke all. He needs somebody to roll.
They have the cones now, so you just got to stuff it.
They got a lot of new shit.
See, Sean know about all the new shit. I don't know about that. We good people over here.
All right, I got two more subjects. I don't know if I covered yours.
No.
So I got two more I'm moving from. So, okay, let's talk about the subject about the young kid running out of his car with the police. The police now are like a threat.
Oh,
what
Yandy posted?
Well, yeah, I seen that everywhere, though.
Yeah, it was everywhere, but Yandy
okay.
posted.
I didn't see it.
And he's screaming for his dad.
And he ran to the door like that. Bang on the door.
Like,
oh.
And
then like, they tased
him. They're fucking him up and tasing him.
Huh?
All of that.
No, the dad eventually came through the door.
No, but he took forever.
Yeah, he did take forever.
I'm trying to figure out where
that's true.
I was kind of wondering if that was the real house. I was kind of wondering. Well, I'm not going to lie. In my head, because I was like, that's some shit I would do.
Did you hear
that? No.
Where's your drink?
They tried to pull him over like somewhere further down. And because it was a dark area, he decided to keep on driving. So he was scared and decided to pull up to his house.
His house.
The cops was going behind him, so they were looking at it like,
You running.
Fuck the cops.
Yeah, I mean,
not fuck the cops.
In this day and age right now, he's a young black man. If he was a little older, maybe I might have said he's a young black man. All he's hearing is people are getting killed and things like that. If he wants to pull up to his parents' home.
But you're talking about the guy. You talking about the guy who ran? Like,
no, he ran to his door.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Okay. I fuck with it. Okay. Yeah. I understand.
We look at it that way.
For
the law would say, call.
The law would say. Alright, so listen, yeah, that's true too. So the law will say he must have something on him or something's wrong that he's not pulled over.
He's scared for his life.
You gotta think, but we gotta think on both sides too. Like,
but
we understand how he's thinking, But yeah. Those people that's in that car don't understand. It's like, you didn't pull over when we got behind you.
That's my
and
problem.
And you kept going, and you pulled up to a house, and you tried to run in. So now it's like...
That's my problem with them. They need to do some more sensitivity training.
They need to definitely need some more training.
They need to understand that as a black man, they're scared for their motherfucking life. When it comes to cops and shit like that.
The only thing I will say is that he didn't even have to get out. He could have been like a 10-2.
No.
Like hands are shown.
No.
Hey, but I'm in front of my house. And a lot
shit, of shit. Shit, if I drive down, I've been calling my dad's phone like, pick up. Like, motherfucker.
Yeah, okay, to my house. I'm
going to just be driving. I'm going to call someone on the phone like, pick up.
Imagine him being at his house and calling people and like no one's answering. He's
well, that
scared.
Was what happened at when he got to the
door.
He was yelling, Dad! And I was like, imagine me not hearing one of my kids. Like,
nigga, I would have been doing the most.
I would have been like,
his dad eventually came to the door. Like,
I would have been going crazy.
Some of the family that was shown just showed him getting taken, but the dad came to the door and the dad was pressing their ass out. But the police, he came and then the police over tried to tell the dad, like, if you don't calm down, you'll get it too. And that was another problem too, because it was like, how you feel like you're gonna tell another grown man if you don't calm down, you'll get it too? And I'm in my house.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get it for what? This is my child that y'all got on the fucking rounds.
That's crazy. I didn't even.
First of all, you're
wrong. Okay, no, because there's another part. That's why I said people have to see the whole video.
I didn't see that.
Yeah, before like you can be like, damn. Now he just get left out there. His dad did eventually come to the door. But it was just. It was too. I mean, they already had him on the ground. They already tased him. And the dad was there, like, going off. All right, so my last topic was about the baby and
his brother
and then mental health awareness, because the baby spoke out about mental health awareness. And if y'all ever know one of his songs, I think the first song on his album, he talked about his brother, the intro,
like he didn't love him,
and he said like he talked about it. I don't know the lyrics.
He said like He feels like he don't move them out.
Yeah, like,
but he said he don't realize that he would give everything up
for
his brother. Even so, but like, we talked about this last week because Nia's little friend killed herself too.
I just feel like with mental health awareness,
mental health is crazy.
People feel alone a lot of times, and I think people always, I feel like us, we'll be like, oh, they'll be all right, but it's another like, no, you really have to sit down and talk to people. Because that's part of my mission statement is mental health awareness, because of playing in the league, a lot of people had concussions and they was going through a lot of things. And by me being able to relate to them, because I played the sport, they didn't care to talk about their family. They didn't want to talk to their mom and all that. They was aggressive to everybody in their family, but then they seen me, they was like, okay, I'm ready to talk.
Because you're okay, though.
Not because I'm okay, because they realized, shit, we done did the same thing. We played the same thing. So if you went through what I went through, so they feel like I relate. They feel like the rest of their family could relate, so they're willing to talk to me. You know what I'm saying? And that's it's all part of mental health. But people, I feel like we need to take it a little more serious and stop just labeling.
The fucking DJ. The fucking DJ.
You're
not
the mental health person right now.
Fucking that, Natasha.
But I just feel like from that standpoint,
I'm joking. I'm
we can't
hey.
Just.
To her.
He hit the green button instead of the red.
He declined the call, basically.
Can we get back to it? Y'all into the Larry conversation. Can we get back into the subject? So, I just feel like with mental health, people, y'all are like messing it up. Because I forgot what I was going to say. Because y'all
said
with
mental health. No, you said with mental health, you feel like we got to take it more seriously, especially us, black
right.
people. Yes, we're here.
But it was like a whole
we
distraction about his phone ringing.
Fuck you. You should have turned that shit down when we said so.
Facts.
Sir.
Yeah, man. It was that message I had and I lost it.
Yeah, it was good. I heard you.
I didn't say it.
No, you said we need to.
That wasn't the message. It was more.
There was more?
All right, DJ. I'll tell you last time.
No. I ain't mad,
but y'all come up with like a real subject, because you never know who was in here, who may be dealing with. You never know
a lot
of things.
That's why we should talk about it.
Y'all, I can't no more. I forgot what the hell I was talking about.
Wait, dealing with what?
Mental health awareness.
Wait, what?
Mental health issues.
You was here.
Mental health
you were,
issues.
Clearly,
you were
but you
here.
Here, but not here.
Wait, I was.
So let's just move on.
I was getting.
Oh, you want to get a drink? But no, we are gonna piggyback. We're gonna go back to that for
let's,
a little bit.
Let's, like,
because
yeah.
No, the reason why
it's very important.
The reason why we're gonna go back to it, not just because.
But y'all was laughing. Y'all was worried about what Larry got
about
going
that
on.
Shit.
But yeah, that's nothing. That's, no, right.
No,
that's
no,
his
no.
Situation.
We were laughing about something else. But what I'm saying is the reason why we're going back is not only because it's important, but because it doesn't just affect black men and black women, but it affects.
Everyone.
It affects everybody,
yeah,
but in our community, we're the ones who would be like, oh, he'll be all right.
That's,
or
big thing.
That's what I was saying.
So that, there we go. So let's get back to that. So that's the big
so
thing.
So guess what? Those other races, thank you. You helped me bring it back now.
What
I'm saying is, hold on. Because now I have it back.
Right.
So now what I'm saying is, so when those other kids will go sit on the couch and talk and get that shit off of them, that's not us. We feel like, oh, we ain't going to talk to them about it. I'm good. It's like, you're not good. And the only way to heal is to talk and to get it off.
Right.
And that's a lot of shit, but a lot of people don't do that shit because they feel like that label them as crazy.
Yeah.
They be like, listen, you have something going on, and you got to get off your chest. Bottle that shit up, you want to explode, you're going to explode in the wrong place, and you it may be around cops, and you may get fucked up.
As adults, when do we like let, especially black men, when do we let them know that it's okay to express how they feel? And that it's okay to cry and it's okay to feel how they feel. When is it?
That's a good question.
It's a question. As black women, no. As black men, like, how do we, like, sorry, am I loud? Am I too loud? Sorry.
No, you're great.
No, go ahead. No,
but I'm saying,
that question for women or?
No, it's for black men.
No, it's for women though, because women.
No, it's not just for women. It's for black men.
No question. No, so the thing is, I get what he's saying. So when the women look at the man weak, if he breaks down.
When he talked to his wife feels like he's a bitch because he's complaining.
Right, that's what I'm saying. When she look at him weak,
then he's divorced.
Not so.
Right.
Then he's divorced.
No,
if she doesn't understand him. And understand
that, man,
you know, as a man, that sometimes, like, it's okay to break down and that he needs to talk and he needs to work and check it out. And she doesn't understand that, then it's a divorce.
Right.
That's a no-go.
But he's stuck.
Say it again. That ain't work.
You know what I'm saying? Like, as a black man and as a black woman, like, if a black man is coming to me and breaking down to me and I understand that he's going through a lot.
How do you view that?
I view that as you need to release what the fuck you're going through. I'm not, you're not weak.
Well, all women
you're fucking
view
strong.
It that way.
No, right. You're fucking strong for breaking down to me and letting me understand how you
some
feel.
Women viewed it as weak.
Can I just say something real quick? Go ahead.
I seen these kids, right. They had gotten into a fight, right?
He gotta say something.
And it was raised by their mom. And
okay.
It was kids that got into a fight. It was on Instagram. And the boy brother was there. Like, it was a boy, two boys that fought. And the other boy brother was there.
Okay.
And he said, get your ass up. He yelled at him, like, get your ass up. You get it. He was like, I can't. It was a heavy step boy. Like, I can't. Go home and get the gun. It was like a joke at the end of the day. But he was like, no, he's going to be tough. Like, that's what in his mind is training is being tough, is yelling and not breaking down.
Let
so
me say something.
His whole thing is, these was kids. And that was his little big brother, whatever. And he felt like he had to yell at him to make him be tough. Like, he didn't want to see on a knee and tired and losing the fight.
Let me say something. I am a mother. I have a 7-year-old son, and I tell my son every time that it's okay. If you're sad, be sad. I don't care what your dad says. I don't care what no one says. If you want to cry, cry. It's okay. Like, don't
let release an emotion.
No, and I said, listen, if you want to cry and you feel some type of way and your dad's making you feel some type of way, do it. Like, I don't care. Like, you need to feel your feelings. And you need to understand your feelings and then move forward.
All right, so what you have to realize is a lot of our parents, grandparents, didn't allow us to feel our
feelings. I'm Haitian, I know. I'm Haitian, I know.
Give me 2 seconds.
I'm Haitian, I know.
Tell us to talk.
Sorry.
Before they throw me on.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Everybody do that, know me. That's here right here real quick. This motherfucker of my cousin over here, bro.
Big old cousin.
Oh, big cousin.
We love you.
We all family right here, but you know, everybody has their own issues, right?
For sure.
But what you're talking about, there's actually,
oh, gosh.
There's actually a group that we have going on that I'm not going to talk about right now, but we can talk about offline, where I have literally, like, the same amount of people you see here
is
all men. And you could come there and you could talk, and everything you're talking about it's a place that you can express what you want to express.
Yeah.
And a matter of fact, my
that's good, but I don't know if I trust it, because I'm like, but pussy ass nigga, you try some shit that I done said in that chat, bitch, and we bumping when I see you.
But it's but it's like
what you saying.
That's me. Shit, I gotta learn to trust. That's
what you're saying.
When you come to that spot, you already know what time it is, and you know who I'm talking about.
I trust you, but I don't trust the other motherfuckers.
Wait, you're saying
but I get it. No, but that's a safe space, and I get it.
It's you're saying it's space. A safe haven for guys to speak how they feel.
It's a legit safe space.
Okay. And that's good. Like, that's what black men need.
We've actually been doing it for about, this is the second time somebody I know has been doing it, and mm-hmm. right now we've been doing it about 5 months.
Expand.
And nobody has come in and been like, yo, motherfucker, you said this. And it's already known. Like, some people came in there. One person came in there with their phone. Now
he's
out of here.
He's giving details. He is giving details. He's letting niggas know that it's the same place.
He's not giving details, right?
No, he's saying that, listen, the organization that he's a part of, that it's okay and it's a safe place for you to come and you express your feelings. That's enough details. That's all you have to say.
So, we'll talk offline, mm-hmm. and I'll explain to you how you can get there. And that's something that we do actually twice a month.
Neff has his hand up.
Yeah,
go ahead, Neff.
What you're saying is cool.
Yeah.
I understand what you're saying. But
which part though? What were we talking about?
Yeah, what part am I saying that's so cool?
As far as people need to, black community need to express what they're going through and all that stuff. But the society we live in today, females are more hard than
females have got aggressive and independent.
I can't hear you. Project your voice so they can hear you.
I can tell you females got.
Speak up so I can hear you.
Females are more harder than the dudes are these
for
days.
Sure.
A lot of dudes are, for lack of a better term, bitch made these days.
For sure.
So
when
a nigga come to their female or go to their lady, yeah, like, babe, I'm going through this and this and that, trying to vent to them. Female look at them like, nigga, you tripping off my man up this at the third. Oh, it happens. Trust that.
No, girls.
I have one question. I have one question. Is
if
this
your woman can't create a safe
that's
place,
the thing,
a safe
I'm
space
saying,
for you?
You right.
That's not the right
thing. I have one question.
Right, exactly.
I have one question.
It's the music. Females so hard these days.
I have one question.
So
I have one question.
Not me, guys.
Dealing with whatever they dealing with by themselves.
I have one question. Is this guy being upfront with this woman that he's dealing with, that he cares about her enough to express his feelings to him?
Yeah.
To her?
Yeah.
Okay. And she's not there for him?
I don't know this situation, but
I'm saying, you know what I'm saying? Let me talk, being a kind of bitch that you're expressing, I am that kind of bitch. But if a nigga comes to me and lets me know that this is what they're feeling and this is what they're going through, and that they're vulnerable,
that takes time.
And they're vulnerable enough to me to express the shit to me, I'm there for you. No
but
matter
what.
As a friend.
That takes time. Y'all be saying shit. That,
no.
Like, you know, be
no.
realistic.
No,
let me tell you
I'm
something.
Realistic.
Let me explain something real quick. Because I get what he's saying. So you have...
That.
You have girls who right now is like,
because
I got my own job, I got this, so it's like, and I don't need no nigga, but then you want a nigga, but then it's like, if that nigga really trying to really be honest with you and say like, damn, da, 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 like, oh, this nigga sounds for like,
because
the woman got to be so hard nowadays,
it's
like a lot of times, some of these women, and not all women is together with the person they with, so now they feel like they got to be man and the fucking woman in the situation raising the kid, so now they like, oh, this weak ass nigga, when I'm the person who now the alpha, like, I got to do all this fucking work.
No.
And then, but wait, on the flip side with some of these niggas, too, is they used to, their mom take care of them their whole fucking life.
Yeah.
Then guess what? They look for a female who's going to take care of them, too. So then that's the same thing. Like, it's similar. It's like, not the same thing. It's just different things, but I'm just saying, like, so you have niggas who used to looking for a female who's going to take care of them. And females do it, and they'll dog them out. But you got a female who might have left that type of relationship, and the nigga might have their own shit, but you get with them, and like, and he weak too, I don't like this, like, you know what I'm saying? So you might like the street shit about one nigga, but he looking for you to take care of him, but then another businessman might be stressed out of work and want to fucking break down in front of your ass, and then your ass is going to talk about, I'm tired of this weak ass shit.
No, I feel like it comes down to perspective. I feel like it comes down to... Like, if you're fucking with a bitch who don't really like you, you waste your time, because that bitch gonna clown your ass. If you fucking with a bitch who care about you, and who wanna see you do better, and who cares about all things about you,
preach!
Wants you to do the absolute most in your life, That bitch is gonna be by your side. I'm still talking. That bitch gonna be by your side, and that bitch gonna help you grow. If you fuck with a bitch who don't like you, just
how,
say that.
How a nigga know if a bitch really like him or not?
Just say that. Thank if you right. fucking with a bitch who don't like you, just don't. Say that.
And I'm looking at a new situation. Mm-hmm. You have to figure out. I'm like trying to bring it back, and I really don't remember the fuck I was
talking about.
I was trying to say it, y'all coming up.
What's the reason?
But like on top of knowing, because you were saying something about knowing yourself. On top of knowing yourself, you need to read the room. If you know that, if you feel in your heart that this bitch is halfway for you and halfway not for you, then that's not a bitch you need to fuck with. You know what I'm saying? You need to fuck with a bitch right. who's all the way for you.
True.
And if that bitch is not all the way for you, you need to fucking move the fuck on, period. Because that bitch will never be for you. If you don't feel like that bitch is for you, you need to move.
But what if what?
Let me help you out.
Let me help you out.
So what if what?
You can't talk right now.
No, talk. Talk. I want to hear.
You can't talk.
But what if what?
All right, so I'm saying, what if she half faking it and then she's not...
You'll know. If that bitch is half faking it, you'll fucking know. You'll know that shit not fucking genuine.
Yo, you faking it?
You know she not faking it. That's why you asking. You know she not faking it. You, but the thing about it.
I think I understand what the question was, though, Susie.
Y'all sometimes, threw me off, and I had a good one. No, okay. Like, I'm mad.
Keep thinking about it, because I'm going to ask
that. It's like the second time it's happened.
Go ahead. No, I was going to say, that I think he's right in the sense that
I'll be too polite. I should have just blurted out my shit. I'm mad. Like, I hate when people don't know what I'm saying.
No, but think, because I think he's going to come back to him.
No, it will.
It will come back.
But I know what you're talking about. Like, because bitches.
That's the problem.
You jerk, bitch. No, but I agree with you that it can be like that. But I hear what he's saying, too, that how do you know that it's genuine? Because you said that a bitch supposed to know, you know what a bitch is for you. And sometimes... I'm not really like I here for you, bitch, but I've been like that recently.
Yeah.
Mm. And so you're not like, here for you, bitch. Oh. Like that.
That's my point. Like it's I've been there recently.
It's
so
subjective.
It's like, how are they supposed to know? That's my point.
It's
how
subjective.
Are they supposed to know that I'm in it's that it. Moment? Right. Yeah, exactly.
Make
so that's my question.
Mikam, do you show them?
You make you
I
wait.
Feel like I'm
do you
not,
do you
I
show?
I'm aggressive, so I don't fucking know.
Mika,
so
do you show that nigga that you for now?
What else I gotta do? I
just know.
What else
she
I gotta do?
She don't want to be vulnerable. That's the problem.
What else I gotta do?
So wait,
tell me what to do.
So wait.
Tell me what else I gotta do.
Hold on.
I'm gonna tell you.
I'm gonna tell you.
Listen.
Everybody got different tricks. They use olive oil.
I'm gonna tell you. Listen.
I need cotton candy.
Listen, no.
No, olive oil.
No. Do you show that nigga that you
virgin olive oil.
A nigga that you care about.
Y'all know what's like. Y'all niggas think it's a virgin olive oil. Oh, you dumb. You even...
Are you dumb? Like, all right. That's the
running
mile. Are you dumb? That's the running mile thing.
You ain't a nigga.
No, Remy Ma says that.
One thing about it is you gotta worry about your saliva either. Once you put that little virgin olive oil on that shit, see, I deal with veterans.
Yo,
y'all get on. I done taught y'all something tonight.
I'm born in 79. yellow bitches more than 35.
You heard what I said. They be like, oh, you got that virgin, you got that olive oil or not? Get that little virgin organic olive oil and go to work.
I'm going out. I'm done.
Y'all think I'm bullshit, all right? I bet y'all check on it. And I bet she loved it. And her motherfucking mouth can be dry as fuck.
This is real,
B-Mac. Is that real? Uh-huh.
He's being serious.
Real as fuck.
Matt, hey, real. Jermaine, he's being dead ass serious.
I am being dead ass serious.
So when they say, oh, I'm going to put some vegetable oil.
She ain't got to tell you shit. All she got to put in her mouth.
No, but when they say, I'm going to put out vegetable
oil. All she got to put in her mouth to make you think her mouth that fucking wet. She ain't got to tell you shit.
When they say vegetable oil.
Man, she ain't got to tell you shit. Put that shit in her mouth real quick. Once you get a suck of that dick, you like, no. Fuck.
So what they do, they gargle it?
No. No, but I feel
you ain't swallowing no red.
No, you ain't swallowing it.
I feel like a nigga. I feel like a nigga know when a bitch like him. I feel like a nigga know when a bitch like him for real.
That's real? I don't know. I feel like some girls can pretend.
Jay, it don't matter. A nigga know when a bitch like him.
But they got 10
like you said. It don't matter. If you feel like, listen to me. Okay, if you feel so like a bitch serious. Like you,
I really want to know this.
Oh,
so
sure,
Kim,
sure.
Yeah. Oh, I can't ask her. Okay, Jay, you ask. No, seriously, do you feel?
Yes.
What's the question? A nigga know when somebody like him.
He know
when
a bitch like
him. So do you know? Do you feel like he like you for real?
Oh shit!
Like he love you for real? Y'all niggas engaged.
No,
he asked her. She
loved
him
more than I love him in the beginning, right?
Oh, she's
She ain't shit. Fuck her.
Give me the mic.
Give me the mic. He said, "Give me the mic." Come sit, take the couch, nigga. But no, seriously.
No, he doesn't.
Okay, so you don't. No, the question is, do you know that that person does? Like, so you do feel that?
Yes, I know.
Okay, so
but
that's
it's
it.
No.
So do you feel like that?
What?
When somebody is in love with you?
I know when somebody like me more than I like them.
Not more. Not, that's it. That's not the question.
Well,
do you know when somebody?
You like me more than I like you, and.
I'm done with Brian.
Love, shit, love, like.
No.
You like love me more.
Okay, yeah, okay. But I'm just saying, do you?
If I feel like I love you more, it's a problem. I'm gonna figure this shit out. I don't like that.
I actually don't like that either. That's the weirdest shit about me. It's weird. Like,
I like
that you like that, but I don't like that. Yeah, it's weird. But. No,
I gotta make you like me more. You gotta stalk me a little bit.
Yeah,
I arguing once in a while.
No, I do like that.
Man, let me know you really like
me. Make me feel like you like, oh, you're about me.
Don't
be
too crazy. I'm gonna cut your ass off.
You're about me.
Right.
Bitch. Why you so
crazy? Don't be too crazy.
Don't be too fucking crazy.
A little argument in there, but a constant argument. You always feel like I'm doing something.
A little bit. Why you wearing that? Nigga, you like me, huh?
Shit, this is
alright.
This
is driving
me crazy.
I don't even think we need to get into the last question of the night.
But you got it!
No, we don't even have to because I think we're at like.
Oh, you said we don't have to get into it. Well, we should because El Blaze not here.
El Blaze is gone. El Blaze being.
So we got one more question.
No, it wasn't even a question. It was, okay. So I was talking to Mac this week. You know, me and Mac were very close and I talked to him about a lot of stuff. And it was very surprising to him. He asked me about somebody. I was telling him somebody kept texting me. And you asked me, like, why I don't text them back. You asked me why I didn't text back. And I said, well, because he's fucking crazy. He smacked the shit out of me. So, I was telling him for the first time a sexual situation where this kid that I actually liked, this guy that I actually liked at the time, he smacked the fucking shit out. So my thing is, what is too much? Is what's too rough?
You
so,
gonna slap me.
So this nigga dead ass smacked the shit out of me.
Whoa.
And then I was like, oh, whoa. But it was a light smack, but the smack shit. And then came back with a backhand. But he wasn't fucking done. This nigga came with a full force of my life. And I said, I gotta go.
I feel like
you probably thought you loved it.
No, I was. Mika. Mika, I feel like...
When I was leaving, the nigga said, you go home. I'm going home. I'm going home.
No,
bye.
I feel like niggas should ask before they do
that's
stuff like that.
That's probably their heart shit.
Nah, you talk back.
No, no.
But in the moment, though,
it's
like hard.
No, okay, so what if I'm in the moment and I feel like stick my finger up your ass?
That's different.
No, that's not. It's not.
I'm using my ass. Fuck my shit.
It's not.
That's way different.
What if I'm
smacking the fucking shit out of me?
What if I'm in the moment... And, like, I'm used to being dominant or whatever, and I feel like stick my finger up your ass. What?
That's way different.
It's not different.
What you mean?
They can just take it out.
It's not different.
Fuck me, bitch.
It's not exactly. No, it's not.
Oh, he's
not.
He's mad loud now. He's very loud now.
I don't do it, but I'm
just very loud.
But I'm saying, like, niggas need to
be. Yeah, but still, like, okay. And then that nigga probably like, but that nigga might slap her. Like,
that nigga might slap the shit out of you.
Right. So, you had that one chance. You had that one chance to do that shit. You probably get checked.
No.
However, this person slapped her three different times.
Three different times.
It got harder each time. So then it's like.
But after the first time,
I know you're gonna get me on here, Beagle.
I told him, I was like, I don't want to talk to that kid no more. He's crazy. Yeah. Like, he's super crazy. He was like, why don't you talk to him?
Yeah.
I don't want, ain't no talking. Like, you should know.
No.
That's crazy.
But you can't say somebody should know if
no.
you never said nothing.
Yeah, you have to say something.
No, right.
Oh, that's crazy.
No, that's just crazy. They should know.
I don't just go around.
He might not feel like she's enjoying it, so he might not.
Right, yeah.
That's why you have to communicate. That's why
communication is the main thing.
You can never assume somebody thinks how you think.
Right.
So you have to communicate.
I went Mac on that. I went Mac.
Yeah,
on that. You
so
have
like,
to communicate, mama.
So when that shit got hard the third time, hey, nigga, like,
no,
you should have said
that.
Not
the
second time.
The
first time, mama.
The first time it wasn't hard.
Yo, I got violated. Let me tell you something. I ain't never felt so motherfucking violated in my fucking life. I was violated. I don't know what to think. I was like, what do I do? Like, when I was leaving, the nigga was like, you leave it, I gotta go home.
Right.
I gotta go home.
Right.
And we live in the same community.
No, you just
I was like, I gotta go
home.
I'm
out of here.
I'm out, motherfucker. I'm out. But this shit was
it ain't never crossed in. That's
wow.
Crazy.
Yeah, that's
a little minute, too.
No, I see him. I see him.
And right, but I'm just saying, it's been like a little minute since it happened, but the fact that you had to ride past the person.
I see him, hey! Like, act like nothing's
wrong.
And then they call me and be like, let's go out for drinks and stuff like that.
Right.
Yes. Right, that's why I said communication.
Yes.
So, okay, I'm going to tell you why. That shit was scary as fuck. Okay.
But why y'all go out for drinks? Communicate then.
No, we didn't go out since then.
No, but you said they called you since then.
Yeah, they did. They did.
So, let's go out for drinks. But let me explain something to you why we out for drinks.
And I
that shit you pulled in the room?
You told me that this week we were talking about it. And I, what's the word? I received it. Brian, shut the fuck up.
Received.
I received it.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah, but they mad loud. They're loud.
Oh, go ahead. Receive.
I received what you were saying. You know what I'm saying?
So maybe you're doing
it? Right. So I received it. And that was the first time that I really had somebody say, like, hey, you should talk to them. And tell them whatever. And
you
I received it.
So you just felt like it was okay to just
I was so
they want some closure.
So we were in Mexico.
What the fuck I did wrong?
No, no, me and Brian were in Mexico with other people and I talked about it in a truck of trust with people. And I told them about it. I was like, this is the weirdest shit that ever happened to me. Happened recently, like this nigga fucked me up in my head. Like I didn't even know what to do because I'm like they Major called me tough. Major said I'm aggressive. I didn't know how to handle this.
They might look you tough too. And aggressive.
I don't fucking know what that nigga thought.
Not the truck of trust no more.
Me too.
It is the truck of trust. But basically, when it happened, I didn't know what to do. And I was just like, you know what?
Hey, ladies. Y'all buy the microphone.
You buy the whole microphone.
Me?
Both
right here, the camera.
No, if she moving, that ain't gonna help. Cause both of y'all talking.
Right,
it's
right. Y'all close to them, y'all.
Right. Sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. But no, I'm just saying that, like, you were the first person to say that. For me, I was like, I gotta go. The nigga was like, you going? I thought you were sick. Nah, I gotta go. I gotta go.
It felt nothing wrong.
And for me, I felt like it was something wrong.
But you kept it internally.
I did. The second time, like, you were the first person that told me, like, why don't you say something? And I was like, maybe because you're the first person I said something to.
Right.
I said something in the truck and
but they did it, but
they
never...
laughed at me. They laughed at me in the truck and
because
said, Brian said that he would smack the shit out of me.
She never made it feel uncomfortable for them, too. Like, to be like...
Right.
If they did it, you never made a movement, like, to make them feel like, oh, shit, she'll
like
this.
No, I don't like that.
Right. So, they don't know that you don't
know. Yeah, they don't know because they be calling out.
Right.
What the fuck they don't know.
So, because you would put that, you internalize that in your brain, like, I don't like this. However, I'm at cool.
No, and for me, I felt so, like, for me, I'm not going to lie, I really should say something or because.
You should have been
saying
something.
No, I'm just saying because for me, it wasn't just like, oh, I didn't like it. I felt super fucking violated. Like, I feel like I don't ever want to talk to this motherfucker. Like, we can't even be fucking friends.
I haven't. And Rob is like, beep, beep.
No, but it bugged me out. Like, for me, it bugged me out. I think it more bugged me out because... I'm not going to say why it bugged me out. It is what it is. Because Jermaine know why it bugged me out. When we first looked the nigga up, how we found.
I ain't saying
nothing.
Exactly.
All right, so, yeah.
He was, yeah. But thanks for coming out. It's been great.
Woo! Thank y'all for the clappings for you.
The quarantine editions have
always
been
dope. Always remind
y'all
that.
Quarantine edition.
You're
like,
you're
freestyle?
No.
Yes. Not rapping. No, you're not rapping today.
No, you
are.
Somebody
asked for this?
No, nobody did. His
just
wife
checking, I wasn't sure.
Only her. Only her would ask
that's, him. She's his manager.
Yes. And booking agent. Okay. She gets 10%.
All the above. Do the flyers.
Everything. Hey, DJ L. Blaze.
Thank y'all for coming out the Back of Make It Live.
Shout out to y'all.